So today we are going to learn how to add decimal numbers. Now adding decimal numbers is very similar to adding whole numbers. The only thing you have to keep in mind is that when you write these numbers one below the other, the decimal point needs to be one below the other. Okay? So you can't write this 2.9 and then you can't write, okay, now here coincidentally the point will come one below the other. But if I take this example, what will happen? 562.9. And if I want to write this below this, some of the children, what do they end up writing? 39.72. They write it like this because the second number is 39.72. So some of them write it like this. Then what happens? This point is here and this point is here, which is wrong. So when I tell them that no, the point has to come below the point only, so then how do they write? They rub this point from here and they put it below this point because all the points have to come in the same line, Miss said. So then they write the number like this. Then what happens? The number that was given is 39.72. And you ended up writing 397.2. You changed the question itself. Okay, so that's wrong. So what do you do in this case? You have to first write the first number as it is given. Okay, and then when you write the second number, what you do is you put the point of the second number first. And whatever digits are before the point, you write them before the point. Whatever is after the point, you write it after the point. So 9 is here before the point and 3 is before that and 7 is after the point and 2 is after that. So that is how you will do this particular question. Okay, so let me do the first one. 2.9 and 1.15. So I finished writing the questions, but I just don't start adding now. Wherever there are digits missing in the decimal part, with a pencil, you will put a zero there with a pencil. Okay. And now you add like you normally add. 0 plus 5 is 5. 9 plus 1 is 10. So you write a zero here and carry 1. Okay. Now this point will come in its place where the point is. In the answer also the point will come there itself. Now 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 1 is 4. The answer is 4.05. Okay. Now if I am to do the second one, then how will it be done? First you write 562.9. Now remember that you space your digits so that they can fall nicely one below the other. Next I have to write 39.72. So I write point here, 9 here, 3 before that, 7 after the point and 2 after that. I'll put the plus sign. Okay, now there is a blank space over here. I need to fill it with a 0. Now I add like I normally add. 0 plus 2 is 2, 9 plus 7 is 16, carry 1, 10 and 2 is 12, carry 1, 10 again. So when you add, you'll get this. Now I go to this question. Now if you look at this number here, 23, it doesn't have a point itself. So what type of a number is it? Yes, it is a whole number. Okay, and we have already learned in a decimal place value table, the whole numbers come before the point. So what happens? This will be written as 23 and then the point will be put. So now once the point is there, I know where to write 18 and where to write 96. Okay, so remember this, very important. Whenever it is a whole number, the whole number comes before the point. Okay. So this point will be put with a pencil and these two zeros. I'm filling the decimal part with zeros. Now I add like I normally add. 0 plus 6 is 6. 0 plus 9 is 9. The point. 3 plus 8 is 11. Carry 1 and 4. 41.96. So it's only how you place the numbers one below the other important, and if there is a whole number, how you write it before the point, that is important.